Hello everyone, Mike Rempel from Excel Bytes with today's Excel Bytes blog post. Today we're going to take a look at how to count items in a list that are an exact match and not just using the Countif function. So let's see how we can accomplish this in Excel. So here I have a list of items, A, B, C, D, E, F, some all caps, some lowercase. And I just show here in this little block here how many of each are in this list. A, B, C in all caps 6, D, E, F in all caps 5, etc. And I've named this list, which you can see when I highlight that from the name box. And I have a drop-down list here with the four different items that are in my list, so we can test each one if we need to do that. Now, if we just use the COUNTIF function, I'll type equals COUNTIF, I'll have my range as list and my criteria as F2, close my parentheses and hit enter. Notice I get 10 when I have ABC as my criteria, and that's because it's taking the 6 that are in the uppercase and the 4 in the lowercase, adding those together, because the COUNTIF function is not an exact match. It doesn't take that into account. So in order to do an exact count of items, we have to do something a little bit differently. So the formula would be equals sum, I'm going to put a double negative there, and then the exact function, I'll use list as my text number 1, F2 as my text number 2, close the exact function, close sum, hit enter, and instead I get 6, which is exactly what we want. If I change this to DEF all in caps, I get a 5, which is perfect. So how does this work? Well, let's go down here and we'll go from the inside and work our way out. If I type equals exact, put in my list, and then F2 is my criteria or my other text item, hit enter, notice I get a series of trues and falses. So in this case, if I move this up here next to my other list or my actual list, and see where are the trues. The trues are any place there's a capital DEF. There are 3 down here, 1 up there. There's 5 altogether in my list, and which is exactly what I wanted. So now the next thing we did was we put a double negative in front of the equal sign. Now there's multiple ways of converting true and false to ones and zeros. One is to put a double negative in front of your function, I'll hit enter, and notice it converts all those trues and falses to ones and zeros. You can also multiply times 1, that does the same thing, or you can divide by 1. All those methods will convert trues and falses to ones and zeros. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go back to having my double negative in front of my function here. Now the last thing, all we need to do then is wrap this in the sum function so that it'll add up those ones and zeros, and now I get the number that I want. So if I wanted to do this list here just to make sure it all's working properly, I would type equals sum, double negative, exact, list, comma, and then I'm just going to choose what's in F8 here, close my parentheses on exact, on the sum function, hit enter, copy that down, and you'll see all those exactly match the count that we have in our list. And that's how you can do that in Excel. So thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so at my website, excel-bytes.com, or at any of the social networks noted below. Thanks a lot, have a great day, and happy excelling.